Hey guys, I'm Gaspachian. You've seen the intro? It's only gonna get worse from here. Today, we are starting a thing. We are going to be playing through career mode using 64k. This is a mod that increases the scale of the default Kerbal solar system by 6.4 times. Together with this, we're going to use the harder solar system generic config. This adds axial tilt to all the planets in the Kerbal system. This will be accompanied by SETI mods, which means we have a probe and plane start, and we're going to use procedural tanks for most everything. For this playthrough, we will be using the mods TAC, KCT, Remote Tech, and others. We will be using the default configs for TAC life support. For Remote Tech, we will use signal delay. This will be augmented by using KOS later to program our probes. KCT can at first be very daunting to set up. Usually, the default config is fine. However, we're aiming for an epic scale playthrough. We want things to take time. Therefore, we have reduced the return on investments across the board. The only thing made cheaper is simulating, since we're playing without an option to revert during flight. A new addition to Kerbal construction time is the ability to have multiple launch pads. Since I have never tried this out before, I'm giving myself a discount to encourage myself to try it out during this playthrough. As we may come to see later, everything here is subject to change. If we don't like something, we will go ahead and change it to make the game more enjoyable in the long run. Apart from the initial configuration shown in this video, we have tweaked and pruned this install to death, adding and subtracting parts, modules, and configurations across the board. Hopefully, the result is a sleek, user-friendly, but challenging progression through the tech tree, with meaningful decisions to be made along the way. This playthrough uses mods and configurations from several dozen developers. Special shoutouts go out to Yimo for the SETI suite of mods, King Tiger for 64k, Stevehead for the harder solar system config, and both Ven and Nerti for most non-stock engines we will be using. Unfortunately, many of the patches we have applied to the installed mods have been done in place rather than using module manager patches. This means that just copying my mod list will not result in an install identical to mine. I will provide a mod list, and I will probably, during the course of the series, highlight certain edits that I have done. You are then free to copy those edits as you see fit. However, I will not be providing a complete list of them, as that would, well, I wouldn't know where to start with that. It's gotten too involved by this point. Please send help. As we saw earlier, we accepted a couple of contracts initially, and we're now building a rocket to fulfill those contracts. We're using procedural parts mostly, which is fine. We're also using triple Z flags here, the most important part in this mod pack. And yeah, I mean, the scripted part about this intro is over, so now you're going to notice that my English isn't actually as good as I presented it to be. But the principle here for our rocket design is that we're going to be relying on SRBs initially. Now, the default configuration for the procedural SRB that's supplied and patched by like three different mods in this install is broken. By default, there is a placeholder ISP value for the SRB. However, this doesn't seem to be overwritten, which means that there are two engine modules running active on the default SRB config, one of which has 10 ISP. So, if you're experiencing problems with that, that's one of the many custom configs in this install that we have changed. What you can also see with our rocket there is that we don't have access to fins yet. However, since we're using Ferrum Aerospace, which isn't relying on a parts-based simulation here, but rather a shape-based simulation, it is perfectly fine to take structural parts and construct fins out of them. Anyways, we've called the marching band, and we're ready to launch our first rocket in this glorious space program. One thing to note about these SRBs compared to the stock SRBs is that there is some gimballing to them. Not much. It's limited to 0.5 degrees. But for now, it's going to be enough to control us into our ascent into space. Into our ascent into space? See, this is what happens when I don't have a script. So yeah, just look at the launch and pretend I'm not speaking. That's going to be much better. So, anyways, this initial mission has as a goal to break through the atmosphere. I don't remember if we accepted a contract to go out of the atmosphere, but I think so. The initial altitude record that's available in SETI contracts is for a manned flight, and we don't have any manned probes yet, as you could tell in the VAB. In fact, we have barely anything available to us right now, except for our solid rocket boosters. However, for now, it's going to do us over well. And our little science probe is heading up into the atmosphere. As you can see, our fins here are working wonders in keeping ourselves stable. It's not going completely straight, but if you've ever tried playing without fins, you know these things tend to flip out quite easily. So we're headed up into space. We're taking all the science we can get, which consists of pressure readings and temperature scans. We also noticed that the music is beautiful up here. That is probably determined to be cause enough to head back up here. Because now we're going down. We didn't move fast enough. In fact, we had to move at about 6100 meters per second sideways to stay up there. For this, it is theorized that we will need new technology. And this technology was fortunately unlocked by taking a temperature reading in space. It doesn't make sense, but we'll roll with it. Anyways, we're pondering our new contracts, because doing contracts is fun. And we're being offered field research contracts here for taking targeted science missions, basically. But instead we go for the progression contract, because one of the requirements there was to visit the deserts. And our Kerbal Space Center here is not where you'd usually find it. Instead, because of the harder solar system, we are located on an inclined position to the northeast of the regular Kerbal Space Center. So this means, coupled with this increased scale, that we're very far from several biomes you'd find nearby in a usual playthrough. But if we're going to aim for orbit, if we're going to aim for reaching 6100 meters per second laterally, we're going to need to build a bigger rocket. And most importantly for our Kerbals, we need to build a multi-stage rocket. This is something they have never done before, but well, they have only built one rocket so far, so it's understandable, I guess. In stock, it's kind of easy to, by accident, build a single stage to orbit. Even if you're not building a plane, just building a... Well, if you're playing with stock parts, building a rocket with a 3.5 meter lifter is going to pretty much end up with you having this first stage up with you in orbit. This is not going to happen by accident here. The guideline recommendation is about 7500 delta V to get up into orbit. You can usually do with less. We also remember that we had another contract to launch with a stability enhancer. We added that in. Turns out that took our weight above the limit for our little mound of dirt that we call a launch pad. So we have to redesign our rocket while it's being constructed, but well, we're doing things for science. And science means launch clamps. So we're going to test this out. And immediately there's something not quite right with this rocket. I can't really put my finger on it, but yeah, it reminds me of modern art. But we're not discouraged here. We're pioneers. We're going to launch this rocket. We're going to take this into space, right? I mean, we're going to try. And we're going to fail. But at least we got paid to test that launch clamp, didn't we? And as you can also see, we got a milestone, because we have finally returned to the surface. I mean, not in one piece, but if they aren't picky, we aren't going to be picky. So, well, that's not going to do us over well. We need to remove the launch clamp. We need to build a bigger rocket, because looking at the values, it's going to be shaky. But with the launch clamp removed, our mass budget is increased. Of course, it's still being very limited by the fact that we have to use SRBs, which burn solid fuel, which is very, very heavy. But we just make small variations and rename our rocket to the Sounding 3 to keep some sort of coherence here. We'll come up with a better naming scheme for rockets later on. But for now, we're going to try to launch into orbit. We'll see how that goes. Now, the first launch we saw in real time, that's going to make this whole series very tedious if we're going to watch every launch in real time, because launches take quite a while in 64K. In stock you could be done in about 3 minutes, you're going to need at least twice that here, unless you're playing with crazy ridiculous thrust to weight values like we're doing with this one. Now as you can see, we're coming in for a pretty high launch, and the reason we aim for that is twofold. First of all, we have very poor gimbaling on this rocket, so we're worried about our control authority deep down in the atmosphere. Second of all, we also play with remote tech, and well, currently we don't have a satellite system up in orbit, so if we're going to have maintain control of this quote-unquote satellite, we're going to have to we're going to have to keep it in visual range for the duration of the launch. So initially we're going to be limited by that more than by many other things. And as you can see, this inefficient launch path has meant that we did not indeed make it to orbit. We're going to stay up here a bit longer than last time, but the ultimate fate of this rocket is the same as our first one. We did break a speed record, so it wasn't all in vain, you could say, but the ultimate fate of this rocket is sealed, and well, we're going to have to try harder next time. See you then.